As you can see on your monitor, on your display, this
Yes.
is the pattern that we can use when we want to construct the positive, negative, and interrogative sentence. Subject, again to be, and then verb. There is ended with ing, and you can also add. Oh my God! Test test. Hello.
Yes,
sir. Masih terlihat?
Masih, sir.
Yes.
Masih terdengar? Saya lanjutkan. Halo? Kok ini nge-freeze ya?
Ya, Mister.
Tes, tes. Masih.
Untuk suara masih jelas,
jelas
Mister.
Masih
untuk
jelas.
Suara masih jelas.
Jelas, sir.
As you can see on your monitor, that if we want to construct the positive sentence, the pattern is the same as you already know in the present continuous tense, and the difference is only the to be. And here, as we already in the previous meeting, that if we can see in this pattern, it is only up to verb that is ended with ing, but actually we can continue the sentences by adding some complement. Seperti yang kita bahas di pertemuan kemarin, kalau dilihat di sini itu cuma sampai verb ing, tapi kita bisa menambahkan pelengkap-pelengkap yang lain. The complement that we can add at the end of sentence, it can be noun, it can be adverb, can be the combination of noun or adverb. Okay, here in the sentence, in the example, she was cooking all morning. She is the subject, was is the to be, and then cooking is the verb. And all morning is the complement. And what complement is this? All morning. Complementnya ini berupa apa? Di contoh ini. She was cooking all morning. Waktu.
Adverb.
Keterangan waktu.
Keterangan waktu. Adverb of
time. Adverb of time.
Ya, adverb of time. Okay, so that's for the positive. Once again, it is very similar as the previous one that we already discussed in the previous meeting. And then let's move to the negative. Okay, do you still remember the characteristic of negative?
No.
Hello? The use of
not.
Hello?
Yes, hello.
The use of not and
not.
Yeah. The use of not and where should we put the not in the sentence?
After to be.
After to be. Okay. And now let's see the example of the negative. She was not sleeping when he came home. She was not sleeping. She was not sleeping when he came home. Test, test, test. Hello?
Yeah, Mr. Hello, sir.
Hello?
Yes, hello. Masih, Mr. Masih terdengar. Masih terdengar jelas.
Okay. Nah, itu untuk apa namanya? Kalimat negatifnya. And now let's see the next. She was not sleeping when he came home. Ini ada dua, ada di contoh ini ada dua peristiwa ya. Satu peristiwa yang sedang terjadi, kemudian muncul peristiwa yang berikutnya. Dimana ketika muncul peristiwa yang kedua itu, peristiwa yang pertama itu masih sedang terus terjadi. She was not sleeping when he came home. Dia tidak tidur saat dia tiba di rumah. Oke. Okay. She, the subject, was the to be, not is the negative indicator, and sleeping is the verb. Yang kalimat duanya itu, when he came home, itu dalam bentuk simple past. Oke, okay, jadi kalimat utamanya itu she was not sleeping itu ya. She was not sleeping. Now, that's for the negative. Before we talk about the interrogative, up to here, do you have any question for the positive and negative? Hello?
Nothing.
Hello, sir.
Nothing. No. As we already discussed in the previous meeting, that to construct the interrogative sentence is quite easy. The only thing that we have to do is only to change the position of subject and the to be. Okay. In the previous sentence, subject is the first order and to be is the second order, but in the interrogative sentence, we change the position between to be and subject, so that the order is the to be in the first position and subject in the second position, and the rest is the same. Okay?
Yes, sir.
The example is, was she sleeping? Was she sleeping when he came home? Was is the subject, and then was is the to be. She is the subject, and sleeping is the verb. Okay, so that's for the interrogative. Any question? Kayak lagi so. Ini sama aja dengan present continuous kemarin ya. Yang beda cuma was were. Okay, if you have no question now, let's go back to the example of positive sentence here. She was cooking. She was cooking all morning. Who can make this sentence to be the interrogative?
Was she cooking all morning?
Gimana coba? Gak jelas suaranya.
Was she cooking all morning?
Oke. Okay. Kita tinggal mengubah urutannya menjadi
was to be di depan.
She cooking. Kemudian sisanya sama. Was she cooking all morning? Was she cooking all morning? Okay, so that's the interrogative. And then how about if we want to make this into the negative? What will we have? Yes?
She was not cooking all morning.
She was not cooking all morning. Okay, next, let's see the negative. She was not sleeping. She was not sleeping. What is the positive of this sentence?
She was sleeping.
She was sleeping when he came home. Dia sedang tidur saat dia tiba di rumah. Okay. So that's how we construct the sentence by using past continuous tense. Okay. No question. Yes?
Yeah.
Okay, if you have no question, now let's see the next. Let's see the usage of past continuous. Okay, as you can see on your monitor, at least there are 4 usage of past continuous. The first one is to describe parallel actions. To describe parallel actions. What is it in bahasa Indonesia?
Untuk menggambarkan tindakan paralel.
What is this first usage?
Yes, sir.
To describe parallel action, what is this in bahasa Indonesia?
Untuk menggambarkan
tindakan paralel. Atau mendeskripsikan tindakan paralel.
Untuk mendeskripsikan, untuk mengungkapkan peristiwa yang terjadi secara bersamaan. So once again, to describe parallel actions, untuk menceritakan, mengungkapkan, menggambarkan peristiwa yang terjadi secara bersamaan. The example is, while I was washing the dishes, I heard a loud noise. While I was washing the dishes, saat saya sedang mencuci piring, I heard a loud noise. Saya mendengar apa? Suara yang ribut. Nah itu ada 2 peristiwa. There are 2 actions in this example. The first one is cuci piring. Kemudian peristiwa yang kedua adalah mendengar suara yang keras. Okay. So that's the first usage of past continuous. And the second usage of past continuous is to describe what someone was doing at a particular point in time. What is it in bahasa Indonesia? To describe what someone was doing at a particular point in time.
Untuk menggambarkan apa yang dilakukan seseorang pada titik waktu tertentu.
Oke, untuk menggambarkan, untuk mengungkapkan apa yang sedang dilakukan seseorang pada titik waktu tertentu. And the example is, I was working in the garden all day yesterday. I was working in the garden all day yesterday. What's it in bahasa Indonesia? I was working in the garden all day yesterday.
Saya bekerja di kebun sepanjang hari kemarin. Sepanjang hari kemarin.
Oke, saya bekerja di
kebun
sepanjang hari kebun. Kemarin. Nah,
taman.
what someone was doing-nya itu adalah what someone was doing-nya itu adalah working in the garden. Kemudian particular point in time-nya adalah
all day yesterday.
Okay. Kemudian the third usage for past continuous is to express interrupted action in the past. To express interrupted action in the past. What is it in bahasa Indonesia?
Untuk mengungkapkan tindakan untuk yang terputus
di masa lalu.
Terputus di masa lalu.
Apa? Gak jelas suara kalian.
Untuk mengungkapkan tindakan yang terputus di masa lalu.
Untuk mengungkapkan peristiwa yang muncul saat suatu peristiwa sedang terjadi di masa lampau.
Masa lampau.
I was driving to work and I crashed my car. Ketika saya sedang mengemudi, ketika saya mengalami kecelakaan. Saat saya sedang mengemudi, saya mengalami kecelakaan. Nah, jadi yang interrupted action-nya yang mana?
I crashed my car.
Okay, I crashed my car. Jadi ketika proses mengemudi terjadi, ketika kegiatan mengemudinya itu sedang dilakukan, kemudian ada action yang tiba-tiba muncul. Itu I crashed my car. Itu ya. Halo? Masih monitor?
Masih sih.
Okay. That's for the third usage. And now let's see the fourth usage of past continuous. It's to describe repetition and irritation. Repetition and irritation. What is it in bahasa Indonesia? To describe repetition and irritation.
Mendeskripsikan pengulangan dan irritation.
Apa itu irritation?
Pengulangan untuk mengungkapkan pengulangan and irritation. Untuk mengungkap suatu peristiwa yang terjadi secara berulang dan peristiwa itu tidak adalah peristiwa yang tidak menyenangkan, mengganggu, ya, annoying action. To describe repetition. To describe irritation, repetition, to describe repetition action, to describe irritation action, repetition and irritation action. He was always complaining in class. He was always complaining in class. Di present continuous kemarin ada juga yang menggunakan penekanan frekuensi kemarin ada kan ya?
ada
terkait dengan frekuensi. Nah, ini mirip. Jadi in this fourth usage we use the adverb of frequency. Kita menggunakan kata keterangan seberapa sering sesuatu itu terjadi atau dilakukan. Nah, dalam hal ini, di contoh ini, the adverb of frequency always. The adverb of frequency used in this sentence is always. Always complaining in class. Apa? Yes.
Dia selalu mengeluh dalam kelas.
Dia selalu mengeluh dalam kelas.
Dia selalu mengeluh di kelas. Oke, dia selalu mengeluh, dia selalu complain di kelas. Ada kata always, berarti ini mengindikasikan peristiwanya terjadi secara terus-menerus, terjadi secara berulang-ulang. Irritation-nya yang mana? Ya, peristiwa dia selalu mengeluh itu adalah sesuatu yang irritation. Jelas ya?
Dia selalu contoh lainnya, dia selalu mengganggu teman-temannya di dalam kelas. Nah, itu juga. Atau dia sering mengganggu teman-temannya di kelas. Sering berarti menunjukkan peristiwanya terjadi tidak cuma sekali, tetapi sudah berulang kali. Dan irritation-nya adalah dia mengganggu teman-temannya itu. That's the irritation. That belongs to irritation. Okay, so that's the fourth usage of past continuous. Any question for this usage? Do you have any question for the usage of past continuous tense?
Nothing, sir.
Any question? No. Yang lain gimana? Yang lain nggak ada yang ditanyakan juga?
No.
Okay, if you have no question. Then
saya stop dulu ya sharingnya.
Okay, so if you have the questions, I will give you some assignment. If you have the question, then I will give you assignment. But the assignment that I will give you will be informed in the WhatsApp group, because the assignment for this meeting will be the combination of the previous material and today's material. So the detail of the assignment will be informed in the group. And have for today. But before we end today's meeting, as usual, I will check your present.
Siti Rahmawati.
Present.
Julianto.
Present.
Mayra Musdalifah.
Present, sir.
Mayra Musdalifah.
Present.
Sahrul Mubarak.
Present.
Alia.
Present, sir.
Present, mister.
Juliana.
Present, mister.
Siti Rahimah.
Present.
Binda Aulia Rahmah.
Present, sir.
Nur Mutia. Nur Mutia, hello. Nur Mutia nggak hadir ya. Ajar ya. Fajar ya.
Ter.
Tidak ada ya.
Ter.
Fani.
Present, sir.
Ahmad Nur Fauzan. Muhammad Nur Fauzan. Tidak ada. Tiara Nur Fatimah.
Tidak ada di room.
Present.
Tiara ada?
Ada.
Putri Sulastri.
Present, mister.
Putri Sulastri Permatasari.
Present, mister.
Rizky Hasanah.
Present.
Yeni Suryani.
Present, mister.
Umi Maisara.
Present, sir.
Wafa Qawlan Syahida.
Present.
Cynthia Lestari.
Present, sir.
Ahmad Rafi Zidan.
Present, sir.
Khalida.
Present, sir.
Khalida Zia.
Present, sir.
Okay. Atma.
Present, sir. Present.
Winna.
Present, sir.
Amy.
Present, sir.
Weni Wulandari.
Present, sir.
Ayu Putriana Lestari.
Present, sir.
Pak.
Present, sir.
Iva Karimah.
Present, sir.
Ahmad Aryo. Ahmad Aryo. Okay. So that's all we have for today.
Sorry, Mr. Nurmati, I'm present.
Thank you for this. And don't forget to relearn previous material about present and today about past. And see you next meeting. Let's close by reciting Hamdallah together.
Alhamdulillah.